kira makan kaya, kami juga penyerah komunikasi keadilan yang kita kasihi saudara visi kami, naik kasih keadilan. Dan saya tidak boleh pulang ke rumah melihat bersama anak-anak Ben. In the last few days before he might be in prison. So please, a round of applause. We pray for his freedom. We pray that he will be free from all oppression under the current government. And kita doakan ya. Kemenangan bukan semata-mata untuk rakyat, tapi juga untuk membebaskan mereka yang bersalah. Menghormati bagi kami selamat Ali Parman, Shah Alam, Dato' Yoh Adlan, Anthony Fidon Adlan, any of the peace that we managed to communicate with Dato' Yoh. Dato' Yoh, lepas ni saya diminta mengingatkan jadi kecil tetap. Because dalam bahagian saya, tak lupakan juga semua pimpinan yang hadir. Saya fikir ada kawan-kawan, teman-teman lama yang bersama yang telah membantu memenangkan di debat pantai ini, termasuk pacar-pacar, my heroes and heroines. Juga my pacar, I would want to stand in here as a member of parliament for debat pantai. Majulah pacar untuk demokrasi Malaysia, saudara Rezali, teman-teman yang saya hormati, kasih sekalian. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Siapa korang sahaja di sini? Banyakkan? Ya? Penyaman saja. Ya, saya hari ini berasa amat-amat gembira. Saya berdiri di hadapan saudara-saudari. It is, imagine this ya. It is the 20th year since reformasi. It is the 20th year since reformasi. Saya tidak mampu untuk mengatakan. No, back in 1998, when I was still very young, when Fahmi Fadil was much younger, not too much younger, just 2 years younger, I think we never expected that this movement for reforms would carry us to the day that we could see former Prime Minister, and as I used to call him, the dictator, Tun Mahathir Mohamad, to be with us, to join in the struggle for change, to join and support the agenda for reform, and to leave UMNO and Barisan Nasional to make sure Malaysia in the future has a future that we can be proud of. Dan itu dalam 20 tahun sudah dari, memang bukan juga ada ramai yang di sini yang datang yang bersama sejak 1968. Ada yang sejak 2008. I know it is not easy. When I was there at the Bersin rally, I told everybody in the crowd, you must feel tired, you must feel fatigued, but you cannot complain. Why? Bukan namanya perjuangan saudara-saudari, bukan namanya kemenangan yang wajib kita nikmati tanpa pengorbanan. I remember, no matter how difficult it may be, ladies and gentlemen, we can stand proud because we have fought this good fight honorably. We have fought based on principles, principle conviction, and sebagaimana yang Datuk Seri Anwar Ibrahim ingatkan. Kita mula dengan agenda untuk menyelamatkan masa depan. Jadi sudah tentu nak bina Malaysia ambil masa. Saya ketemu anak pengundi baru. Saya ketemu pengundi-pengundi yang ramai yang sekarang bertempat di Balai Polis Ibu Pejabat Bukit Aman. But do we allow these challenges that we have to face to make us feel sad, despondent, filled with despair? Never. I decided, together with Fahmi Fadil, the whole team of Lembah Pantai, Saudara Izzahar, Timbalan Ketua Cabang, Kak Zura, Ketua Wanita, keseluruhan tim, termasuk Anna, the entire bangsa clan, yang memang pakar dia untuk memastikan tidak ada penipuan di masa pilihan raya. Nah, ini kebakaran bangsa. Termasuk orang kecil dapatkan orang di belakang. Tak orang kat belakang. Tak orang ni orang anggur pun takut dia. Nah, dia bukan boleh memecahkan saja peti undi rosak, tapi mereka punya keberanian. Kenapa? Kerana kita tidak percaya dengan penipuan. Bila kita buat sesuatu, kita berdasarkan keadilan. So, ladies and gentlemen, sempena hari polis yang ke-211 di Lembah Pantai punya anggota polis yang paling ramai untuk mengundi dalam pilihan raya. So, sometimes people confuse me. They don't call me member of parliament for Lembah Pantai, but they call me the member of parliament for Bukit Aman. And I'm proud. I'm proud of my constituents. I make sure that this police day, we bake organic day cakes. Kek kurma organic, guna tepung gluten free. Apa? Orang bangsa yang boleh guna gluten free? No. Kita perhatikan orang tak mungkin aman rasa kek yang gluten free, brown sugar and everything organic. Hantar. Hantar ke semua balai polis di seluruh Lembah Pantai yang manis dan sedar-sedari. Abang-abang polis, termasuk kakak-kakak polis, datang kepada saya. Wadi Nurul Izzah, jangan bimbang. Kali ini kami juga akan bersama untuk urus perubahan. Bukan kerana kek, ya? Bukan kerana kek. Kerana mereka tahu, jauh di lubuk hati kita, kita mampu perjuangkan masa depan mereka. Kita fikir tentang rasuah dan kepimpinan yang tamak akan rubuh. Maka kalau Perdana Menteri umum 1.5 bilion ringgit pun sempena hari polis, nak dekat pilihan raya, mereka boleh fikir kuartas polis macam mana? Begitu teruk tempat tinggal mereka. Anak sakit masih kerja dalam shift. Siapa nak bawa anak pergi hospital? Ke hospital, tak sedih dah mereka berlum. Di balai polis ni, menteri-menteri mana tahu, tak pernah tertangkap. Ni muka tertangkap. Rafizi, Wadi Khalid, ya? Saudara Fahmi, ini muka-muka. Kami tahu keadaan lengkap semasa. Maka kamilah yang lebih arif untuk memperjuangkan bagaimana balai polis lokap-lokap harus diperbaiki kondisinya supaya penjenayah di Malaysia ini menjadi lebih baik, bukan menjadi lebih macam barisan nasional. But this is the aim. When you understand society, that like you mentioned, his experience, yeah, in civil service, in the diplomatic corps. When you understand, you live through it, then you can feel the pulse of the people. Boleh merasakan apa sebenarnya rakyat lakukan, hatta anggota polis sekalipun. Saya mungkin kena ditangkap, tapi saya punya keprihatinan yang jauh melebihi mereka-mereka yang menggunakan polis-polis atasan untuk melakukan kerja terkutuk mereka. There is a difference, ladies and gentlemen, my dear friends. When you understand, when you have sensibility and common sense about the things that matter to the future of this country. Imagine Datuk Seri Anwar Ibrahim. I'm telling you, 10 years, by this year, 11 years of his life spent incarcerated. 11 tahun dalam penjara, saya harus tekankan. Bukan sesuatu yang mudah. Tapi bila kita seringkali menyebut kita mampu kuasa rakyat, kita mampu pertahankan agenda reform, datang Tun Mahathir Mohamad ke mahkamah selepas 20 tahun terdekat, tangan dihudut, apa yang dibuat oleh Datuk Seri Anwar? Beliau jabat tangan tersebut. Salam demi masa depan. Salam demi Pakatan Harapan. Salam demi memastikan kita menang untuk menang. menyelamatkan Malaysia yang kita cinta.
Because the end is so desperate. They are so
Because SPR, the Election Commission, the final component party of Barisan Nasional, can add on as many postal voters until the D-Day itself. Dia boleh tambah lagi, maksudnya kita kena pastikan di setiap masa apa yang disebut tadi. It is important, you have to be watchful. And I'm confident because for me, orang merasa tekanan. Tak cukup dengan itu lagi, tak cukup tu Barisan Nasional, tak habis lagi. Hari Isnin sambung akta, rang undang-undang, lawan berita palsu. As you know lah, everything in Malaysia is fake unless it comes out from the mainstream media. What happened is, they will approve this because semua di Malaysia sekarang menggunakan media sosial. Facebook Live, whether it's the one functioning by Inbook or most of the political leaders, Pakatan Harapan, ini yang cuba mereka hentikan siarannya. Tak mau rakyat lihat, tak mau rakyat nonton, because this is the only way. Can you imagine when the DOJ announced the asset seizure, more than 5 million people watched it online. I'm telling you, they can't run away, and that's why they're making all these desperate measures. You have never seen a government so fearful in the history of Malaysia. And that says a lot. Atas dasar itu, saudara-saudari, bila bersatu, dan terkini, mungkin keseluruhan logo akan diharamkan. That means they cannot have their own office, they can't have their own finances, they can't have their own logo to be used. And this is the moment where Pakatan Harapan is truly tested. And I am really, really proud to tell all of you, not only keadilan, but also amanah, we were more than ready to offer our flag to be contested by all of Bersatu's candidates. Boleh saudara-saudari bayangkan Tun Mahathir Mohamad bertanding bawah keadilan? Picture that for a second in your mind in this 20th year of reformasi. Ladies and gentlemen, Tun Mahathir Mohamad having to contest on Parti Keadilan
proud of your parents for buying you a new car.
You can be proud of your parents and Shafiq for agreeing that you married the love of your life. But I think one of the key things that he taught me is kita hidup berprinsip. Dan kalaupun keadaan sukar, kita tentu boleh menang, kita boleh terus bersama sekiranya kita istiqamah. So just a little bit more on the selection. We gave you dinner tonight. There's no such thing as a free dinner or free lunch. We need to work on this forever, together. Dan kita harus ingat juga, dalam berjuang, karena itu malam ini saya tekankan dan saudara fahami, karena fahami masuk dalam keadilan, borang bagi pada saya. Dan fahami Fazil juga, bila kali pertama dia ketika itu berumur 16 tahun, dia bersemangat. Bersemangat, apa?
18.
Oh, bukan underage lah. Taklah muda sangat situ kan. Boleh tahan lah. Dia ketika itu sudah mesti merasa tertangkap. Dia pada fasa nak cuba jadi hero. Dia pergi ke balai. Nak cuba, yelah kan, dia nak diinspirasi terhadap Cik Anwar Ibrahim dulu. Semasa Tun Mahathir Mohamad, bukunya The Malay Dilemma was banned. He went to basically salvage the situation and to save some of his friends who were detained in university. Dengan dia juga masuk lockup. Itu dah kisah Pak Fazil. Nak selamatkan cikgu rasa saya, dia pun masuk lockup sekali. Di umur 18 tahun. But I mentioned him, why? You know, I came to be, I am who I am because of the love of the people of Lembah Pantai and the trust they placed in me. Dan bukan sesuatu yang saya mahu menyimpan, maka kalau diarahkan oleh kepimpinan keadilan pusat supaya saya pergi terpaksa bertanding di kawasan lain, saudara-saudari, this is not confirmed, you can have yourself for some time. Saya hanya ingin nyatakan orang yang tepat in my eyes you will have, I think, not of equal, not just of equal standing, perhaps even better. Saudara Fahmi Fazil will fill up the seat. Bro, yang menang, rakyat yang menobatkan sesiapa pun selaku wakil rakyat, selaku ahli parlimen. And sometimes we forget, the ones that will be contesting and winning is not YB Nurul Izzah, YB Rafizi, YB Mukris Mahathir, even YB Mahathir Mohamad. I mean, we are merely your agents. We are merely your voice. And our strength is derived from your support, from your trust, from your Whether it came from a Chinese culture, Malay culture, Indian culture,
This is Malaysia that we want to defend.
Jadi saudara-saudari, teman-teman, bantulah kami. It will be a difficult and arduous journey. It will not be easy. But I feel very optimistic. I feel there's a surge of hope. I feel that we're looking at a new dawn in Malaysia. Kita semua datang dari latar belakang yang berbeza. Tapi ini negara kita. Ini perjuangan kita. Ini masa kita. Maka jadikan masa depan milik kita bersama.
So, okay, you know the KPI for Bangsa is always 11 at night. I'm going to keep up to that. My fundraisers always end the earliest. You're welcome. And selepas ini, saya dapat beberapa sukarelawan, Dato' Yoke Sansoga. Kita akan pastikan senarai sukarelawan di lepas pantai. As I said, apapun, we have to make sure you guard this place very well. Saya nak kita juga wujudkan squad khas. Bukan untuk bakar banyak-banyak kek, tapi memenangi hati anggota polis. Remember, I managed to escape arrest twice. Why? Because I'm the friendliest to all the policemen and policewoman in Lembah Pantai. I can teach you the trick on the trade. But you must make sure we are in this together, that we fight a good fight until the end, until G14. See you all in Putrajaya, ladies and gentlemen. My love.